Londres. Como muchas gran capitales del mundo, esta es una ciudad que nunca duerme, y en mi reciente visita llegué a experimentar exactamente eso. Yo viajé a Londres con una meta: descubrir 24 momentos únicos, uno por cada hora del día. Desde bares secretos a conciertos privados y tés lujosos a mercados de comida, recorrí toda la ciudad en busca de los siguientes momentos. Ahora voy a compartir lo que ustedes también pueden hacer con 24 horas en Londres.
Well, good morning. It is 7 a.m. here in London. It is my first morning in the city and I've just woken up at the Citizen Emma Hotel. And wait until you see the views outside my window. I have the Tower of London right across from me.
No desayuné esta mañana, pero por buen motivo. Había un pequeño café en Hampstead que tenía que visitar.
It's 8 a.m. and we just dropped by Café Barocco, and that may be the smallest little coffee shop I've ever been to. It's set in an old red telephone box and they make some delicious coffee. I actually ordered myself a latte.
Con un poco de cafeína en mi sistema, continué a mi próxima actividad, subir Parliament Hill en Hampstead Heath. Este es un mirador con vistas de todo Londres en el horizonte.
Aside from offering great views of the city skyline, this is a beautiful nature escape. You have woodlands, walking paths, and lots of people walking very friendly pups.
So it's currently 10 a.m. and we're on our way to the Tate Modern. This is actually my favorite art gallery in all of London, so I love revisiting every time I'm in the city.
Ubicado dentro de una antigua central de energía, esta improbable estructura alberga la Colección Nacional de Arte Moderno y Contemporáneo. Pero no solamente vine a esta galería por el arte, sino también las vistas.
So we are currently in the Blavatnik building and this is a new extension here at the Tate Modern, and they have a viewing deck that is 360 degrees. So yeah, you can walk all around and get some amazing views of London.
De ahí me bajé en la estación Westminster y caminé hasta Horse Guards Parade para mi próxima actividad.
And it is now 11 in the morning, so next up I'm going to be watching the changing of the guard and then I'm going to go visit the Household Cavalry Museum. So now that the changing of the guard is over, we're going back into the Household Cavalry Museum, and you can actually look into the stables and watch the horses come in and the guards dismount.
Si visitan con niños o simplemente quieren disfrazarse, también hay una sección dentro del museo donde uno puede probarse un montón de uniformes.
Alright, so it is 12 o'clock and we're currently on the Thames. We're about to do an adventure and adrenaline-filled tour. You guys ready?
Yeah! Yeah!
Un paseo en bote por el río Támesis es una experiencia clásica en Londres, pero Thames Rockets hace las cosas un poco diferente. Este tour te pasea a lo largo del río, tocando música y compartiendo todo tipo de datos interesantes sobre Londres que no encontrarán en ninguna guía turística. Después de esa aventura, yo estaba más que lista para almorzar.
So it is now 1 o'clock and that means lunch. Today we're here at Borough Market, which is the oldest market in all of London. Apparently it dates back over 1,000 years. So we're gonna go find ourselves some food.
Con cientos de puestos de comida que venden desde panes hasta batidos de frutas y mariscos frescos hasta hamburguesas, no tardé en encontrar un delicioso almuerzo.
So for lunch, I went to Gourmet Goat and got myself a kid goat kofta bowl with two different salads. And this looks really, really good. Check out those colors. A very vibrant dish, so let's see how it tastes. That's an explosion of Mediterranean flavors.
Después de esa comida necesitaba un postre y lo que más me llamó la atención fueron las donuts.
So for dessert I got myself a little something sweet from Bread Ahead. They're supposed to have some of the best donuts in all of London and I got myself the classic vanilla. Oh my goodness. Filled with cream, so much cream.
¿Qué se puede hacer en Londres a media tarde? Yo me fui al West End para ver un show.
It's a beautiful theater, my goodness. So it is now 2 o'clock and we're currently at the Prince Edward Theater. We're going to be watching a matinee. Aladdin, this is my first time watching a West End show, so I'm pretty excited. Also, I love the movie Aladdin. That's a childhood classic, so.
Y ahora una tradición inglesa, la hora del té.
So it's 3 o'clock and we're here at the Sanderson London for a Mad Hatter's afternoon tea, and it's time to try some of these delicacies.
Tomar el té en el Sanderson fue como ser transportado al mundo de Alicia en el País de las Maravillas. Le pusieron una atención única a los detalles, desde el menú hasta las teteras y las botellitas que decían bébeme.
So it is 4 o'clock and we are currently exploring Seven Dials. This place gets its name from the sundial and the seven streets that break away from the dial. So yeah, I didn't even know this place existed. It's near Soho and Covent Garden, yet it has a village feel. It's really cute, lots of boutiques, restaurants, cafes. So I'm now taking you into Neil's Yard. This is still part of the Seven Dials, but it's got a bit more color. It feels more bohemian, super artsy. It's like being inside a rainbow.
Después de pasearme por tiendas vendiendo joyas, chocolates y bolsos de mano, paré en una pastelería a probar macarrones.
So we've been wandering around Seven Dials for a little bit and we happened upon Pierre Hermé. And they have these beautiful macarons. Check out those colors. So right now I'm going in for raspberry, rose and lychee. So right now it is 5 o'clock and we are at Queen Elizabeth Olympic Park and we're going to be riding the ArcelorMittal Orbit. This is the tallest and longest tunnel slide in the world and honestly, I'm feeling a bit nervous. Excited, nervous, a little bit of everything.
There we go.
Very fashion forward
you
here.
You are now in full orbit swag.
Oh my god.
Okay, so
how you
feeling?
You want is... I feel nervous now. Alright, we're higher than the Statue of Liberty right now.
Yes.
And we're gonna ride the slide.
Stuck it right there.
What have I gotten myself into? I feel like I'm going into surgery.
So, head forward and up. Okay. Go for it.
Alright. Bye!
So a little bit shaky, but I survived. I was screaming the whole way down and I actually didn't even realize I had come out of the slide and I was just lying there and I was still screaming. So they actually had to like shake me awake, like, it's okay, it's okay, it's over.
Continuando mi paseo por Londres, tomé el tren a Croydon, un barrio conocido por su arte. Aquí aprendí un poco más sobre Rise Gallery, una galería que ayuda a conectar artistas locales con propietarios, lo cual ha resultado en hermosos murales que visten edificios por todo Croydon.
So right now we are walking along a stretch known as the Legal Wall, and this is basically open to the public. Anyone can come here and just have fun with some paint and get creative.
Siguiendo con el tema de arte, para mi próxima actividad asistí mi primer Late en Londres. Esto es cuando los museos y las galerías extienden sus horarios y organizan eventos especiales. Yo asistí a un evento a fin de verano llamado The Other Paradise y los invitados vinieron disfrazados para la ocasión.
So this is my first time attending one of the Lates and I've thoroughly enjoyed it. It just has a really different feel from going to a museum or a gallery during regular hours. It's a lot more relaxed, it feels more like a social outing, you see large groups of friends enjoying drinks and viewing art. So I would highly recommend it if you find yourself here in London.
A las 8 de la noche fui a un concierto privado organizado por So Far Sounds. ¿Cómo funciona? Es que uno se registra para asistir a un concierto sin saber qué banda va a tocar. Justo 24 horas antes del evento, te envían un correo electrónico con la dirección y otros detalles. Así que es una forma interesante de descubrir nueva música.
And we're currently at Pop Brixton. This is a really cool container park where you have bars, cafes, restaurants, shops. So I think it's time we find ourselves a little bit of food because we've had a long day and I'm hungry. So it is now 10 p.m. and we're at Draft. It's a board game cafe, so we're gonna play some games. The only question is, what do we choose? So many options! So we've settled on a game. We're gonna play Riff Raff and build a pirate ship, apparently.
Luego, a las 11 de la noche, me di una vuelta por The Blues Kitchen in Brixton, donde todas las noches tienen música en vivo.
Fun. The show just ended and we all had a really good time. We were actually listening to a band from the Netherlands that did like jazzy orchestras. It was really unexpected, but really fun.
So it is now 12 o'clock and we're at Flight Club. This is a really cool bar where you can come and play pub games. So we're gonna try our hand at darts. We've got some friends waiting for us downstairs. Let's go in.
Flight Club es un bar donde uno puede ir a jugar dardos, y es aún más divertido si vas con un grupo de amigos. Yo fui sin ningún tipo de experiencia y no me fue tan mal. Con el reloj marcando la una, mi siguiente parada fue Cahoots, donde fui transportada a Londres en la década de los 40.
So it's currently 1 a.m. and we're at Cahoots, and this is a 40s themed bar, and it's all about the underground here. I feel like I'm about to ride the tube. Also, they just brought us the menu. It's a newspaper, so we're just gonna have a look through here and choose some drinks. So it is 2 a.m. and we are currently in Chinatown, which is known for its late night haunts and dim sum. We have chosen Opium, which is a bit of a hidden gem. They only have a tiny little sign and you have to look for the jade door. So let's see if they let us in.
Este bar queda en un ático en Chinatown y es otro lugar divertido para visitar. Aquí preparan todo tipo de cócteles y yo pedí uno basado en el año en que nací.
So here at Opium, the drinks are based on the Chinese animal zodiac. I'm 1987. Turns out, I'm the year of the rabbit.
¿Cómo hemos hablado tanto sobre la vida nocturna en Londres sin visitar un club? No lo sé, pero eso cambió a las 3 de la mañana. Coco queda dentro de un antiguo teatro, así que tiene varios niveles y es un lugar único.
All right, so it's 3 a.m., still going strong. We're here in Camden, and we've just been inside Coco. This club has the largest disco ball in all of Europe, and yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's really packed in there. So it is now 4 in the a.m. and we're at the Bagel Bake. I've ordered myself a salt beef bagel, which is massive, by the way, almost the size of my face. So let's tuck right into this.
That's a lot of meat. And a lot of mustard. Spicy mustard, I have to say.
So it is 5 a.m. and I am currently enjoying a little morning stroll along the south bank of the River Thames. Got Tower Bridge in the background. And yeah, the city hasn't quite woken up yet. Rush hour hasn't started. So it's very peaceful, very tranquil. And I think it's a beautiful time to be out enjoying London before everyone else wakes up.
Y para la última actividad de mis 24 horas en Londres, fui a desayunar en Duck and Waffle, un restaurante que está ubicado en el piso 40 de uno de los edificios más altos de la ciudad y que también está abierto las 24 horas del día.
So here we have Belgian waffle, confit duck leg, a duck egg, and we also drizzled a mustard maple syrup all over. This is going to be tasty.
So that was a really good meal. It was the best duck I've ever had. So tasty. And now let's enjoy some views over London as we go down 40 stories.
Y eso concluye mis 24 horas en Londres. Espero que hayan disfrutado este gran tour de la ciudad y que también hayan sacado algunas ideas para su propio viaje. Como ya pueden ver, Londres tiene mucho que ofrecer, no importa la hora del día, y es un lugar que vale la pena conocer. Les deseo felices viajes y nos vemos en el próximo video.